Hello, my name's John McGrath. I'm a producer for Flatland at Kansas City PBS, and I'm here to tell you about the film Big Fur, directed by Dan Wayne.
People look at Ken as the Elvis Presley of taxidermy, if you will.
Well, Big Fur is really a story about unrequited love. It's a biographical documentary, and it follows Ken Walker, who is arguably the best taxidermist in the world. And Ken is obsessed with Bigfoot. And over the course of the film, he creates a Bigfoot and then unveils her at the World Taxidermy Championships in Springfield, Missouri. You know, to me, I was always interested in it because, you know, it's kind of weird, for one thing, right? And then I love that kind of marriage of art and science. And I also love, you know, these art forms that are mostly craft, but sometimes they kind of rise above that into an actual artwork.
I wrote an article for Breakthrough Magazine some years back, and the term I coined was Ken has magic in his hands.
Ken is real unique in the world of taxidermy because he specializes in recreations. Now, the guy has worked at the Smithsonian. He's been in National Geographic. He can do anything taxidermy-wise. But a lot of taxidermists will specialize in fish or birds or mammals, and Ken can do all those very well. But he's known for these recreations.
He has made animals, taxidermied animals, that don't exist. He has made an Irish elk that was fabulous. Saber-toothed tigers, he's done those.
So these are extinct or endangered animals made out of other animal hides. And it's a real unique thing, and it requires a lot of research and creativity.
I was looking at witness drawings, and there was one witness drawing that I liked where the Sasquatch, when the person saw it, they looked up and the Sasquatch had pulled some leaves back and was looking at the person. So I just decided to emulate that particular pose.
I knew Ken had a thing about Bigfoot, but I didn't know, you know, how obsessed he was with it. And when I approached him to see if he'd be interested in being part of the project, he told me he was going to make a Bigfoot. And that's when I thought, I found the movie right there.
The Patterson-Gimlin film remains profoundly important and remains extraordinarily difficult to dismiss.
To watch that film, and as Ken says, to look at the anatomy and the way that the animal moves, and then the fact that it has breasts, to me is like, who would fake a Bigfoot and put breasts on it?
One almost has to drop one's jaw and say, well, golly, maybe it's the real thing. And I still think it's probably our single most important piece of evidence.
Every civilization has reports of seeing this ape-like creature there.
You know, the truth is there's a lot of things that happen in the woods that we don't know about. You know, it's just, there's just a lot out there that we really don't know. So, you know, there's people that are certain that it exists because they've seen one. And then there are people that say there's no way because we've been everywhere and we know everything. And then I kind of fall somewhere in the middle where I think, man, it sure would be cool if it was discovered. And what would we learn from that?
In dreams, I walk with you.